Hello, I'm Graham, and I hope everyone's having a great day, and welcome to this fifth and final part in this series where I've been looking at the FZ80-82 again. Now, in today's video, we're going to be talking about actually shooting video with this camera. Now, currently I'm recording the video with the FZ82 in the 4K 25p mode. I'm using a variable ND on the front of the lens to allow me to reduce the amount of light entering the camera. It's a bright sunshiny day, and normally we'll be using a very, very fast shutter speed to stop the action. Now, for cinematic reasons, you want to have a shutter speed which is approximately twice the frame rate that you're shooting at. So here I'm shooting at 4K 25p, so I need to be using a 1/50th of a second shutter speed. I've got my ISO dialed down to ISO 80 to give me the best possible image condition, and that meant that I was going to be shooting at quite a high aperture. So by introducing neutral density to the front of the lens, I can reduce the amount of light reaching the camera. So if you're going to be shooting at a 30th of a second, you obviously want to double that to a 60th. If you're shooting at 50 frames per second, you want to be using a 100th. And it will depend on the amount of light you've got in your situation as to whether you're going to be using 25 frames per second or 50 frames per second. Now, the higher frame rates give you smoother motion, so if you wanted to be slowing down your footage to show some slow motion type effects, if you're recording at 60 frames per second or 25 frames per second and you're reducing that to a 25 or 30p timeline, then you're getting a 2x speed reduction, so you get a lot more smoother motion. Obviously, you can shoot in the higher frame rates with a camera up to 120 frames per second, but you lose the facility of capturing audio. Now, the unfortunate thing about the FZ80-82 camera is the fact there's no audio input socket on the camera, so you are relying on the internal microphones to pick up the sound. Now, if you're outdoors and it's windy, you're probably going to run into a situation where you're going to be picking up wind noise as the air passes over the ports on the top of the flash housing there. So at the moment, I'm using an external microphone and an external recorder to capture the audio, and I've synced that to the audio track by using my little gadget that I designed. It's basically just an LED and a bleeper, so when I press the device, I can see the LED, I can see the pips on the timeline, and I can sync that track to the camera track so that I've got perfect sync between the audio and the video. Then I can delete the camera track, and that's a standard post-production technique, but normally a clapperboard would be used, or you clap your hands together. I just thought this little gizmo that I designed would be a better option, so I've posted that on my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below if you wanted to make your own device. Well, currently I'm using a small pocket recorder to record this audio. It's the Tascam DR10C. It's a pass-through recorder, normally used in series with your transmitter if you're using a wireless mic, but I'm just using it today as a standalone audio recorder. You could, of course, use your iPhone or a smartphone to record the audio if you've got that connected, so you could actually record a voice and then again transfer that over to your video. Alternatively, you could use an external audio recorder such as this Tascam DR40. You get good audio from it. Again, you'd have to sync that in post-production. So again, the use of the audio synchronization device or your clap to enable you to capture that sequence, so you could actually sync your audio and video together in post-production. At the moment, I'm recording in 4K 25p, so that gives me the minimum angle of 28mm. It goes up to something like 1600mm if you've not got eye zoom on, so it gives you a fairly good zoom if you want to be recording wildlife videos. But of course, as you get to those extended zooms, it does soften off a little bit because of the lens quality, but you can still get some good video at that extended zoom range. I'm going to switch over now to recording in the 1080p mode. You obviously get down to 22mm when you're recording video, so I'm going to zoom in slightly to match the same frame that you got with 4K, so we've got the same framing, so it's going to be around about the 28mm position. Now, if you are recording in 4K, you'll see a much better video quality if you're downscaling to 1080p in your video production. So I do advise, if you can record in the 4K mode with this camera, it's going to be an MP4 file, which should be easier to edit on your PC. You can actually get better video quality than you can record in 1080p mode. So let me just set up for 1080p and you'll see the difference in quality. Both are on the 1080p timeline. I've got the camera set up to record in 1080p. I'm using 25 frames per second. My shutter speed is still 1/50th. My aperture is about f4.5. ISO is 80, and I've reduced the light by using the Freewell 2-5 ND stop filter, and it's at 5 stops. Again, using the internal mics to capture the audio, but using an external audio recorder to capture the actual audio that you're hearing in the video. I've actually post-production synced this to the camera audio track and then deleted the camera audio. There's a lot more definition in the 4K mode, so that's a mode that I would really recommend you use if you're going to be shooting video with this particular camera. So that's it for the video. Hope you found that useful. I hope you found the series useful. And if you do, please do recommend it to your friends. Share it on social media or whatever. It does help in running on my channel. So I do appreciate if you do that. If you're a new viewer, of course, please do look at the previous videos in this series. You might learn something more about your FZ80 or 82 camera. So until the next time we meet, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care. I hope to see you all then. Goodbye for now.